Hello, my name is Amy Ecker, and welcome to my channel. So I have a box of empties. Whoops. So I want to share with you some of my empties and the things that I have repurchased. So let's get started. We'll go ahead and start with what just fell out of the box. So I don't know if y'all have seen this at your local grocery store or at Walmart, but this is Dr. Bronner's Magic Soaps. So they have this one, and I have another one that's in lavender. So this one's tea tree, and you barely put just a little dab of this soap in your hand, and oh my God, this stuff takes off. Like, it multiplies. So you barely need any of this magic soap. So what I love about it is the smell, or the fragrance in it is so clean and wonderful. And you can actually dilute this and use this as a cleaning product. The one that the lavender, you can use it, adding it as a dab in a washcloth, kind of heat up your washcloth and put it over your eyes. And it's almost like being in a spa and helps with kind of headaches. So I've done that before with this. Really and truthfully, this is probably one of my favorite products ever. And if you haven't tried it, you need to. Plus, it's organic. Who doesn't love some organic products? So do try that. If you have tried it, let me know what smell is your favorite. This I'm absolutely hooked on. Then in one of my subscriptions, I want to say it was the test tube subscription like months ago, I got a hair rescue treatment, and this is basically amazing. So I do dye my hair, and I did do a perm not too long ago. I was trying to go for the beachy waves. And so my hair at the ends have been really damaged. So I pulled this little baby out and used it. And oh my God, so you put it on the ends of your hair, and it gives you like a little cap, and you can put it on for 5 to 10 minutes. I actually left it on for about 30 minutes because again, my hair is really, really damaged. And afterwards, my hair was so soft. So I'm actually keeping a copy of this so that I can order another one, because it was fantastic, or it is fantastic. Speaking of the test tube, and I keep looking down because I've got to do a review on two test tubes, is the Balancing Recovery Mask. This one treats blemishes, oily skin, and redness. I love sheet masks. I love great sheet masks. And this one is an excellent sheet mask. So I'm keeping this one also so that I can order some more. I really like just absolutely kind of doing a full kind of day spa. For me, that's pretty much what I do every Sunday. So to be able to do a moisturizing mask and then a facial mask, this says it delivers 10 times the hydration. Again, I kept this because I need to order some more of these. It did make my skin feel amazing. Love, love, love this. Okay, so dry shampoos are kind of my friend also. The ends of my hair are dry, but up at, towards my scalp can be a little, sometimes get a little bit greasy. So, for lack of a nicer word, what I like to do is take the dry shampoo, and this one is Tresemme Fresh Start. And before I go to bed, what I do is section off my hair, add some dry shampoo, and then when I wake up in the morning, my hair is fresh and ready to go. So the Tresemme Fresh Start Volumizing Dry Shampoo is one of my favorites. And that's another bit that I have repurchased. I've got so many things in here, I don't know where to go next. Okay, so again, in my test tube, I feel like this is a test tube review. I got this little tester. It's called Embrylisse, Embryolisse. It's from France, and it is a concentrated moisturizer. Yes, I have oily combo skin, but I still like a good moisturizer for my face. This thing was so good that I went on Amazon and bought the full size. So every night after I do my different serums, this is the last thing that goes on my skin, and I'm freaking in love. So not only have I enjoyed using the test piece from Test Tube, thank you, Test Tube, for putting that out. Again, a shout out to Test Tube, because obviously they're giving great products. I bought the full size, and this is amazing. And the smell is, it's like clean. It's just, I don't know, it just is amazing. So really love that. Okay, I mentioned I have dry hair. So I'm a YouTube junkie, and so I was watching these different things on how to cut your split ends, and I found this little comb. It's a hair cutter. It's called by Tinkle. So you can cut your hair as you comb it, and it's supposed to only like basically hit your split ends that are kind of popping up. It's got two razor blades on the inside. I'm sure that whoever used this on YouTube just knew what they were doing. So, and I don't know that you can really see, but there's some long hair still stuck in this. So I just wanted to do kind of a don't buy this unless you are really, really a professional, because let's just say I didn't have a good look and maybe I'm missing a chunk of hair that I've had to try to blend. So just be careful of that one. So that's actually going in the trash, but I wanted to forewarn anyone else before you made a mistake like me. Oh, speaking of dry shampoos, one of the other ones I did like, I want to give a shout out to the Double Take Dry Texture Spray, and this one is Not Your Mother's. So there's two different ones that I've enjoyed using. If I'm not mistaken, the Trace May one was a recommendation, one of those, or maybe both, was a recommendation from the Makeup Mom. So if you haven't watched the Makeup Mom, I've got her link below. Check her out, because she does a lot of product reviews also. So some of these great ideas come from her. And actually, there's a third one that I've tried, and this is the True Original Instant Dry Shampoo. This was actually a recommendation from a lady at Ulta. So as you can tell, I've tried different dry shampoos, but those seem to be the ones that I gravitate towards. Okay, so if you like, no one likes cleaning their makeup brushes, let's be honest, it sucks, it's not fun, hate it, but the best brush cleaner I found is by It, and it's called Brush Bath. Not only does it smell nice, but it's kind of got a bit of a lavender smell to it. But the thing that I like about this one also is that it cleans your brush without leaving like a soapy residue. So I had bought Ulta's makeup brush and sponge cleaner. This one, I'm gonna continue to use it. It's not that I hate it, I just don't love it, because I don't like how the brushes seem to have a bit of a soapy kind of feel to it. And they don't look that pretty when I'm done cleaning them. So here's kind of one. They make your brush look raggedy. Again, I don't hate it, don't love it. This one, I freaking love. So this needs to be on your purchase list, just saying. Okay, so I'm jumping all over the place. Let me try to finish hair products, maybe. Okay, so the other hair products that I love is this is actually, it's the Matrix Essential Sleek Look. It's number 4, the Iron Smoother. Okay, so don't really like the scent of this. I guess it's got kind of a more of a chemical smell to it. So I don't like the smell on me, but I still buy it anyways. And why do I buy it? Because it freaking works. So it does give a nice sleek look. You spray this on your hair as you're, before you flat iron it. It does great. But ladies, let me tell you what else it works for. So if you are going to curl your hair with curler or rollers, yes, I still bring out the rollers, putting this all over your hair before you roll or curl, you're gonna get some maximum staying power with this. So if you have not used it, despite the smell of it, which you may not like the smell, I would recommend this. So this I buy over and over regardless of the smell, just because it does an amazing kick-ass job. Just saying. Okay, one of my other hair products is Olaplex. So I believe I've gotten this out online on Amazon also. So Olaplex is a nice hair bit that is for damaged hair that keeps on being color treated. So I've ran out of this. I need to repurchase it. But you can use this basically once a week. You comb through it, you sit it on your hair for 10 minutes, and it kind of helps your hair recover and rejuvenate your hair. It does not weigh my hair down. I also have fine hair, so I really don't have issues with this kind of weighing it down, but I like the way that it protects my hair for the next time I go to damage it with hair color. I'm getting old. I got a lot of gray. So as far as body products go, I've got a couple here. I've got the 613 by Wynn. This is a lovely, lovely lotion. So this smell is absolutely great. You absorb it quick. It's non-greasy. It's got a lot of essential oils, botanicals, and extracts. And so, oh my gosh, ladies, this is kind of like a lemon. I don't know how to describe it. I wish they had what the main bits are. Oh, they do. It's lemon, rosemary, and vanilla bean. So, oh my God, ladies and gentlemen, this is absolutely amazing. Smells so great on the skin. However, I will say, don't buy the perfume. Do not buy the perfume. The perfume does not smell like this at all. In fact, it smells like goat piss. Not that I've put my nose down a goat piss, but I can imagine. Do not buy the perfume. It smells nothing like this. This is heavenly. Speaking of heavenly smells, one of my empties, and I always go back to purchase it over and over. In fact, this is kind of my signature perfume. I don't wear anything else other than Burberry Brit. It doesn't matter where I go. If I hug someone new that I'm just meeting, they always say, oh my gosh, you smell so nice. Burberry Brit is one that it just smells fantastic. It's not florally, but it's not too clean smelling, but it just smells amazing. So I actually bought this because I was on the phone with one of my guy friends, and he was using a phone from a girl at work, and he said, your phone smells so good. And I asked him, I said, okay, if you're saying some lady's phone smells good, ask her what she's wearing, because I'm really curious. It was Burberry Brit, so I go and purchase it, and I've never gone back. I think this has been my signature cologne or perfume for almost 10 years. I'm trying to think back of how long I've actually wore it. Maybe not a full 10 years, but pretty damn close. This thing, amazing. Again, it's my signature smell, and I don't wear nothing else. Okay, so the next product, ooh, I said I was finishing up with hair products. I lied. I have been using the Grow Gorgeous, and this is End Split Ends. It's a leave-in serum. So at night, after I finish doing my little dry shampoo on the scalp, I will take a little bit of this serum, put it in the palm of my hands, and just work it on the ends. So by morning, it's had a chance to absorb, and I'm ready to go and style. Really like this. Again, my hair is dry and damaged. Okay, another product. I'm sorry, I guess I've been keeping all this stuff way too long. So another product that I absolutely love, and I'm actually on auto ship from Amazon.com because I love this so much, is the Scandinavia Makeup Finishing Spray. I actually am on auto ship for the primer spray and the finishing spray. The primer spray comes in a bigger bottle, so I haven't finished using this. Love this. But the finishing spray is the Coupe de Gras. Okay, so if you really, really want your makeup to stay on all day, as you add like your foundation, I will spray, then I'll put my powder on, I'll spray, then I'll do my blush and eyes, then I'll spray. When I do that, the makeup really doesn't move all day long. I mean, it does not budge. But if you don't want to do all those layers, I certainly understand. Just doing one layer at the end of your makeup, it still has amazing setup. The technology is that it has bits that kind of release throughout the day that's supposed to keep your makeup in place. Again, if you layer it, like if you're getting married, go ahead and layer it, or anniversary or special dates or whatever, your makeup is not gonna move. Scandinavia has an amazing formula that is unheard of. I've used other makeup setting sprays, and to me, I might as well use water. The Scandinavia product, off the hook, love it. Okay, so I do love my serums and my oils. I do them right before I go to bed. I've got a little bitty box that holds a few of them, and I like to try or put them on before I go to bed. One of them is Kyle's Midnight Recover Concentrate. This has a lavender smell to it also. I'm a lavender junkie, I guess. But this oil, when you put it on, your skin absorbs it, and it just has so many great nutrients in it, and your skin just feels amazing. So even though I have oily skin, using this oil does not make my skin greasy. It just hydrates the skin. So I highly recommend this. As far as makeup goes, I have some fun ones. I say they're fun. The L'Oreal Magic Lumi pen is great for under eye brightness, and it's affordable compared to, say, the Sharp Tarte Shape Tape. I always say Sharp Tape Shape. Anyways, that's a good one. So if you need a dupe, that's a great one. Now, the other two that I absolutely love is the Lash Sensational from Maybelline. These I've purchased again and again. So these never let me down. I love the one in the pink is for just regular, and the black is for waterproof. Love, love, love these. Okay, and again, I gotta give props to the Makeup Mom, or Sabrina the Makeup Mom, because she turned me on to these and I haven't looked back. I mean, I have tried other ones and I've had new favorite ones, but I recently just picked these up again after I went through a favorite phase with a few other makeup mascaras, came right back to these, and I'm like, why did I ever leave these? I love them. I love them. So thank you, Sabrina the Makeup Mom. Shout out to you on that recommendation. A couple things to finish out. This one is an eyeliner from NYX. It's called Disco Queen. So I finally kind of ran out. Actually, I've used it so much that it's now dried out. So the Disco Queen is absolutely gorgeous. If you put this or pair this and go over your eyeliner, it's kind of a bluish black, and it picks up light at night like you would not believe. In fact, I went out to dinner with one of my friends, and she was like, oh my God, Amy, what do you have on your eyes? So as a present, I went ahead and purchased one for her and sent that to her. But this I've used so much that it's now empty. And you can't even see it. I've used this till it's gone. And then lastly, one of my favorite lip liners, and I was actually separating lip liners today. I'm just having a lip liner problem. Either this, they're not really working on me as well as they should, or I don't know what my problem is, but basically I'm having lip liner issues. But the one that I keep going back to over and over is Revlon Color Stay. So whatever Revlon Color Stay has in it has been absolutely amazing. I don't have trouble putting these on, and I don't have trouble with them shifting. So I want to give props to Revlon Colorstay. This color is in chocolate, and I love this one. I think I've got like 10 of them because I bought a bunch of them just in case they went, since they changed colors. I bought like 10 of these just so that I would have a backup. That's how much I love the chocolate one from Revlon. So holy crud, I just went through a ton of products, and these are all the ones that I tend to go back to over and over again, or for the new product, like the sheet mask and the hair mask that I've just tried once. I did go ahead and keep that so I know what to repurchase because I loved it that much. But everything else I keep repurchasing. I just love them. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did love this video, or maybe even just liked it, I don't know, give it a thumbs up. I would like to hear some of your comments. So if you have any suggestions for me, that now that you kind of know what kind of products I love, please put your favorite products below. I'd love to try them. And as always, you have an opportunity. Make it a beautiful day. Until next time.